Hello friends, welcome to Lucky Gate. This is a question from the subject compiler design, asked for 2 marks. Coming to the question, here it is given a grammar and asked to find which of the following grammar is not left recursive but is equivalent to G. What is left recursive grammar? Left recursive grammars are of the form a tends to a alpha for some derivation. It does mean that the leftmost symbol in the right hand side should be the same non-terminal as that in the left hand side. The leftmost symbol in the right hand side is the same non-terminal as that in the left hand side. Such grammars are called left recursive grammars. Here left recursion will be again direct or indirect. Here, direct means we have some production or of the form is of the form A tends to A alpha, where leftmost symbol in the RHS is same as LHS. Now, what is indirect left recursion? Indirect left recursion says that some steps after the derivation, you are going to repeat with the same kind of productions. What actually meaning is, if A tends to B alpha and B tends to A beta. So here you don't have direct left recursion with respect to A production and with respect to B production. Why? Because leftmost symbol in the right hand side of A tends to B alpha and LHS is different. Similarly, leftmost symbol in the right hand side of a production, that is B tends to A beta, is not same as LHS of a production. But observe friends, here on repeated application of these productions, A tends to B alpha, if B is to be replaced with A beta, now you are going to get A tends to A beta alpha at some step of the derivation. Because at some step of the derivation it is repeated, now the leftmost symbol is A, now is same as LHS of a production. Now we call it is indirect left recursion. It means directly you don't have any left recursion, but indirectly it is satisfying the left recursion. Now question is, which of the following grammar is not left recursive? I will check with an option A. In option A, we have a direct left recursion. Why? Because the leftmost symbol in the right hand side of the first production in option A is same as LHS. We call it direct left recursion. So option A is incorrect. Option B, you look T tends to T plus F, where the leftmost symbol in the right hand side is same as LHS. So here is also a direct left recursion. So option B is also incorrect. Look for option C and option D. In option C, E tends to TX, X tends to minus TX epsilon, T tends to FY, Y tends to plus FY epsilon, F tends to open, E close are ideal. Here you do not have any direct left recursion. Check for option D. E tends to TX, open TX, X tends to minus TX plus TX epsilon, but you don't have any direct left recursion. So it means option either C or D could be the answer. Now here the question is to find which is not left recursion. How to eliminate left recursion? That we have to understand. Now what is the left recursive productions are of the form A tends to A alpha or beta. If it is left recursion can be eliminated by replacing this one with A tends to beta A dash and A dash tends to alpha A dash or epsilon. These are the two productions. How these two productions are derived? Here, see A tends to A alpha. Again, A is to be replaced with A alpha. It gives you A 2 alphas. Again, if A replaced with A alpha, A 3 alphas possible. Means if you go on repeat it, what you are going to get? A multiple alphas possible. It does mean that this A at some step in the derivation means A tends to beta is possible to replace it. And this alphas are repeating for infinite number of times, that whatever is repeating for infinite number of times I am calling A dash. It means it is representing a production A tends to beta A dash. With A dash what I have to get it, I have to get this many number of alphas, means I can represent it as alpha A dash. After some finite number of alphas, this input string is to be stopped, the derivation, means parsing has to be stopped. It should be epsilon. So means a tends to b, a tends to a alpha or beta is eliminating the left recursion by rewriting the production rules as a tends to beta a dash tends to alpha a dash or epsilon. This is a process. Now here you look, e is a, this minus t I am calling alpha, this t is I am calling beta. Now it is in the form of a tends to a alpha or beta. Now left recursion is eliminated by rewriting the productions as a tends to a is e, now beta a dash, that what is beta t, a dash is nothing but a dash. But see, in option C and option D, such kind of convention not used. But observe it here, e tends to t x is used, e tends to t x is used. Means instead of assuming it as e dash, we assume it is x. And what is that x should be? X should be, x is nothing but a dash now. X should be alpha a dash. What is alpha? Minus t. Minus t a dash means here x we represented or epsilon. Now this is representing a production e tends to tx, x tends to minus tx epsilon. This is matching with option C but not with option D. So we conclude that option C is correct. Now we'll go ahead with the remaining. Now t tends to t plus alpha. Now t is in the form of a and plus alpha in the form of alpha, plus f is in the form of alpha and f is in the form of beta. Now how it can be removing the left recursion? A tends to means t tends to beta, that is f a dash. A dash means here for a dash it is using y, comma a dash tends to means y, alpha a dash means plus f y dash, plus f a dash, that is y or epsilon. Now plus f y epsilon, this is correctly matched and you don't have any left recursion with the third production. Third production is as it is. So answer for this question number 36 is option C. Option C is the correct answer for this question. This is a question asked for 2 marks. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.